the players make their way onto court, led out by the officials. So the player at the back there, of course, Chen Qingchen. We saw her in the mixed doubles final. On the wrong side of that one came runner-up with a partner, Zheng Siwei. As 7 seeds to Zhu and Ma.
Okay, about toss. Red and blue, what size? Red? Right? No, blue.
Okay.
Right?
落雨发球。
So there we have it then. Luo Ying and Luo Yu. World ranked 7th. He's been as high as world number ones in March earlier this year. The players in red. They've only played 2 tournaments together in 2016, though. They made the semi-finals of the All England Open and also first round of the Malaysian Open, a title that they won in 2015, turning our attention onto their opponents. Jia Yifan, just ranked 18, aged 18, I should say. And her partner, who we saw earlier, both 18 years old, ranked 13th in the world at the moment, and they are 2 fast risers, these two. Six quarterfinal showings in 2016. So they've surpassed their semi-final showing here last year when they were ranked 70th in the world. They're now ranked 13th. That is a huge step in the right direction, and that is due to the fact that they've had 6 quarterfinal showings, and indeed their last 4 consecutive tournaments were quarterfinals as well. So there's head-to-heads, the Lu's leading in that regard. The All England Open, round of 16, they came through that encounter. That's the only time that they've met. But the fast risers, though, really are climbing the rankings quickly. In yellow, on the right of your picture.
Ready and, to play.
They have a bright future, you'd imagine. So it's going to be Chen Qingchen. The short hair approaching the camera. Jia Yifan, 2 18-year-olds taking on the might of the top seeds. So both players in red have hit the ultimate goal, the career high of 1 in the world, and that was only a month ago. So they are also playing very well, but they've not had great results of late. They've slipped down to 7th on the rankings. But probably because they've only played twice this year. So what can they muster against the youngsters?
Ladies and gentlemen,
let's find out in this all Chinese women's doubles final.
And on my left, Luo Ying.
Our umpire is Su Shefeng from China.
Chen Qingchen, level.
And service judge, Fan Hibo.
Service over, 1 love.
China, such a powerhouse nation since the millennium in women's doubles. Chen Qingchen, of course, on the right, bottom right of your picture now, with the short hair in yellow. She's had exposure out here already today, and she contested that mixed doubles final very, very well, losing out 21-17, 21-15 in just over half an hour to the might of the 3-time titlist Su Chen and Ma Jin. So she should be able to get off to a flyer, you would imagine. But her partner doing some good work there. but unable to power their way through the red team, who turned that point around beautifully. It's all about forcing the play, trying to get onto the front foot, aiming to get the shuttle down ASAP and involve that front court player quickly. See normally in women's doubles a lot of drives. The blocks to get onto the attack first. And attempting to get the shuttle down quickly. Often makes for compelling viewing these women's doubles matches simply because it's, you know, you've not got the man as you have in mixed to power the smash away emphatically. They're so good, but it was a short lift. The women's game really has become quite explosive in itself. And one power smash delivery that we've seen earlier was in that women's singles final. Multiple heavy smashes from Sun Yu, 22-year-old, who lost out to Li Jure in three games. An emphatic scoreline, 21-6 in the deciding game. Just over an hour of that contest. So two of the three contests so far, the finals, they've gone with the seedings, but Lin Dan, as ever, upsetting the seedings, the second seed ousting the top seed and world number one. She was sold on the short serve and desperate to pounce. As you're got caught napping there with the flick serve over her head. Good disguise from the server. Youngsters preempting that move. Good passage of play then. 4 points in a row for Chen and Ya. Going in, she did right to play it, Luo there. But that, a really long, grueling point, and psychologically important to be on the right side of that one. It's a tough point to lose. So the youngsters, again, marginally in the ascendancy, just a 1 point game. Thank you.
7-6.
Well, these two red-shirted combination, the top seeds, the Luos, won the Dubai World Super Series final last year in women's doubles. But look at this, will you take a look at this? It's quite miraculous, isn't it, that you've got these guys here who've been world number ones and two 18-year-olds from China, as we've seen all week, are just neck and neck. Indeed, they're in the lead, the two youngsters. It's quite something. Of course, it's all about the big points, and eventually, well, normally, it all pans out for the senior seeds. But, you know, they've just got such talent. Such depth, the Chinese, in world badminton. Only 18 years old, quite remarkable. Saw a couple of brilliant 19-year-old men playing in the men's singles. Lin Dan ousted them both, but loss of a game to one of them. And that's something that even Chen Long couldn't muster. But the plus that the two youngsters have in yellow and blue is that they play a lot of tournaments together. They made six quarterfinals, as I said, at the top of the program in 2016. And a round of 16 as well. So they're on a roll of results, and they're playing off their career high ranking of 13th in the world. Their opponents only eight spots ahead of them. Indeed, let's say six. My maths isn't great because they're seventh and these guys 13th. So. Nice. And they're having fun on court. Isn't that the most important thing? Just enables players to play freely and enjoy their badminton and bring out their best. It's a sport that demands an intense but relaxed approach for the fine motor skills to be at their maximum. With soft touch and silky hand skills. So to the mid-game interval then, it's Chen and Xia with a four-point advantage over the top seeds. 9 minutes played. And there was a little bit of an exodus from the stands when, after the men's singles event, people just wanting to take bathroom breaks and perhaps a little bit of fluid on board, perhaps a little snack. But they're gradually spilling back in because there's been some quality badminton fare on offer all day here, from the first shuttle hit to the last. If you are just joining us, we saw Zhu and Ma winning the mixed doubles up first, then Li Jure winning the women's singles. Lin Dan ousted Chen Long in straight games in the men's singles. What a contest that was just recently, probably 20 minutes or so ago. Now we're on to the women's doubles final, and following that, the men's doubles. So do stay with us here.
12-7.
And of course, don't forget as well that our coverage, when we finish here, you can join us for the Thomas and Uber Cup in May. I'll be alongside fellow commentators and legends like Gillian Clark, dear friend of mine.
12. Thank you.
again. Shuttle spills wide and the youngsters extend their lead. 5 points between them. And then just that little bit more alert, synonymous with the fact that they've simply played more together and just a bit more match tight, if you will. First slice was nice, but not the second.
9-13.
Well, once the fourth seed were ousted in the bottom half of the draw, it left it rather open to an ambush for opportunists, such as the yellow and blue team. Top half, well, likewise, not much seeded presence in that beyond round one, frankly. The loser only yielding one game en route to the final. That was against the Thai team, whose names I'd rather not pronounce. It's Bill Long.
15-9.
Good leave from Chen. Well, they've had a couple of really important runs of 4 points, the youngsters. Momentum very much with them.
10,
now, can the top seeds claw this lead that the youngsters have back? Chen Qingchen frustrated there, thought she should have been there. Wonderful.
11,
we love those hard, fast, furious, flat exchanges. That's what good doubles is all about. Smash. 12 slices. Yeah. Defense is immaculate in this point, so tough to kill the shuttle. having to rebuild and rebuild both teams. Now there's bragging rights in this one. Nobody wants to lose this point. It's been going on for an eternity. Crowd loving the action. There it is. And a salute from Gia as they finally put the point to bed. Just about manage a smile after that lung-busting point. Longest rally of the tournament, that, I would imagine. Not that I've seen them all. And brightly allowed a little slack. They can grab a quick drink and a towel down. But it's a four-point game in favour of these two. Chen Qingchen and Jia Yifan. Qingchen with the short hair. 16-12. Now, can she redeem herself, having lost the mixed doubles title to Zhu and Ma? Yeah, quick to close. Very alert. Luo there.
13-17.
Now, big moment for these two, Chen and Jia. Can they close out against the might of the top seeds here in this opening game? She went for it.
14-17.
But it didn't pay off. Thought about it though. So in contrast to the last point, she makes the power smash that time and extends their lead to 4 points. So struck above the waist, service fault called. Confusion amongst the Luos. Great slice finish there from Jia. He's come good over the last few points. Very good play. Such disguise. Wonderful slice. Again.
20, game point, 15.
From Chang. So that brings up 5 game points. Top seeds in danger here of conceding this opening game. Dubai World Super Series winners. Not yet, though.
16-20.
Now, these two have to be careful. Their intensity doesn't drop. They've done a sterling job so far, but they're going to have to work extremely hard now because the fish fights hardest when you get it to the boat, in fishing terminology. Now, they've come through, though. 21-16 in just 22 minutes played. So the surprise finalists then from the bottom half of the draw coming good. Powerful overhead, yeah. And Chen backing it up with some wonderful touch around the net, and indeed showing us her power on the smash. Both of them playing some wonderful slices towards the end there. Complementing power with touch with great effect. So as the music volume descends, play will resume, but it's the yellow and blues in these two 18-year-olds that are a game up. 2 minutes sign will be taken away shortly. Just discussing some last minute tactical nuances. And you can see again another coach insight, respectfully, because China plays China. It's not going to be so in our men's doubles final upcoming. It's the battle of the all Korean outfits. So can the Luos turn this around? Trailing a game. They were trailing a game 21-10 to the Thai pairing earlier in the week in the second round. Came through 21-14 in the decider. Here they go now in the start of the second game. First game to Chen and Jia. With all of their big title experience, these two in red come to the fore. Former world number ones, for those of you just joining us, back almost a year ago now, March, nope, I beg your pardon, a month ago. Youngsters immaculate in defense, and it's giving them a second bite of the cherry. They're managing to turn these points around nicely as a consequence of getting that extra shuttle back and quick to pounce on the turnaround. Seeing it so early and just hitting it to the space, making it look very, very simple at times, these two. Half-court pushes, a little bit more decisive.
Service over. 2-0.
too much, long of the back line. And I think in a nutshell, we've seen Chen and Jia just changing the pace within the rally very, very effectively. Great variation and tactical awareness. What I'm talking about, some wonderful slices. In response to that, the two Luos just not entirely sure about their court position, where they should or shouldn't be, and they come too close, they're getting rushed. If they back off too much, they're getting caught by the slice. Two in a row, though, for the Luos. These two so adept normally with the flat game. So good at getting onto the returns so early normally. Missed. 5-3. Oh, she's found it. Wonderful smash.
Six,
piercing three. The line. Okay. And in a way, it's kind of refreshing to see a change of scenery. And these guys have been at the top of the game for so long. And to see the underdogs and the youngsters coming through, it's just, as I say, refreshing is the word. But that said, the two Luos, keen to turn this one around, shown by the scoreline. So a bark of approval from Chen.
4-6.
Well, it was the first match from Chen that set it up well. She got a lot of power behind it. Good front court control from Chen. Very nice. Straight net shot. Beautifully struck. Well, they're still smiling, which is encouraging. Sport has to be fun at the end of the day. It's that that keeps us coming back. Of course, it's great to get good results, and it's a must, of course, to a certain level, but it's good. They're enjoying this. So they've brought it back level, then, the youngsters. Normally, when you watch top seeds play and There's normally a sort of air of inevitability, an undertone of quality oozing from what we would anticipate the top seeds here, ranked inside the top 10 still, despite only a couple of tournaments this year together. But they look slightly undercooked, and these youngsters playing well above their station, punching above their weight, so to speak. And it's just had a little bit more imagination and variety. Look at this. Brilliant.
Nine, seven.
Jia just quick to back up that Chen smash. Luo unsure if that one was going out. So from 6-2 up for the Luos. Now they're trailing 7-9. Just when we thought normality was about to be restored, the youngsters snatched the momentum back. And you have to say at the moment, they're complementing each other just that little bit better as well in that aggressive stance of one up, one back. Conversely, the Luos in defensive position. Oh, but that's a good turnaround. Nice flat, hard drive right at the chest of Jia.
8-9.
It's all about rack it up when it comes to the flat hard drives. You've got to get it up. It's going to be coming through pretty high, and you've got to be alert. You want to minimize that distance the racket has to move. So if you can get it up around your face or head quickly, it's going to come rifling through. Well, close, Chen. Well, the Luo's not taking too many risks, a little bit passive with their intent at the moment. And yeah, wrong racket angle for that one. It was coming at such pace, though, their flat hard drive from Chen. So the youngsters heading to the mid-game interval with the advantage here. She's missed it.
Survey over. 9-10.
The youngsters certainly do have the air of players who feel very at home on the big stage. There's an inner belief. They've done all the hard work, the training, and they're managing to blow holes in the defenses of the Luos. Wonderful turnaround there.
10-0.
Power, speed, passion, and drama to the full unfolding on finals day here in Changzhou. There's a contented purr around the arena. They've had their fill. They've seen some wonderful badminton. And it was always going to be like that after that men's singles match, which was just so dramatic, as indeed was the mixed and the women's singles too. But crowd lulling in energy at the moment. But it's Luos that are ahead. They've done well to turn that around and get to the mid-game interval with the advantage. 11-10 up, despite losing the opening game. 3 points in a row to Luo Ying and Luo Yu in your picture. Now, have they got what it takes? They certainly have the experience. Are they undercooked here this week? Are we going to witness order being restored in this all-Chinese battle? The women's doubles from Changzhou. Top seeds here in red, having conceded the opening game, 16-21, are on the fight back here. They're a point ahead, 11-10 in the second game.
12-10.
Trying to gee herself up, is Gia, ironically, excuse the pun, having lost the last couple of points. Wonderful slice finish from Gia, because there was a change in complexion on the match. 4 points in a row for the top seeded red team this end. But that was a brilliant finish to a long, tough point. You can see it meant a lot to her. A look of real intent there. Need to claw themselves back in to level here, the two youngsters, because you feel the experience and changing tactics of the red team. Top seeds, former world number ones, coming to the fore now, using all of their experience. It's a lovely change of pace, real acceleration from Luo.
13-11.
They compounded the pressure on the left court player so well there, just pummeling her with a barrage of short drop shots, lulling her forward, and then power smashes. It's So it's a one-point game. The youngsters still with work to do. Chen to serve. Chen Ching Chen just missing that one though. 3 point for the red team. That'll delight them at this stage. Big moments these. Been on court for 41 minutes. It's been a contest, a tight contest throughout. Good play. Good power smash from Chen Ching Chen to seal the deal there. Flat exchanges. Well, she's opting for the challenge, but sadly we don't have it here at our disposal. So, the Luos 2 points ahead in this tight second game. We've witnessed some long, long rallies. Wonderfully reflexive defensive skills, some great blocks and pushes from both teams. Good speed, agility, just missing that final shot. That was good, just a little too cute. And that look at the end of it says it all. They're trying their hearts out here to get across the finish line, but they're being denied by these two. Who are playing some really spirited badminton at the back end of this second game. 16-30. Well, they're pressing forwards, the youngsters. But to no avail, they're a little too errant in doing so. Attempting to rush the Luos into error, but it's costing them at the moment. So a 4 point advantage for the top seeds now. Who incidentally have won the last 3 points in a row. Case of deja vu, already seen it about 4 times. Well, they're just locking down the defenses, the red team. Top seeds just so frugal in error, giving nothing away right now. And it's earned them their patience and diligence, a 5 point lead. 4 in a row for the Luos. Showing such work ethic and determination in their quest for the winner's check. And title. Well, the fight back is really well and truly on here. 2 points from levelling up then at a game each. The Luos. It's all change. Well, that's the first error for quite a while from these two.
14, 19.
Relentless in pursuit of that early shuttle. Watch this. Got on the front foot. Doing a great job in the forecourt at hunting down the shuttle. Insistent on winning the point. So here we have 6 game point opportunities for Luo Ying and Luo Yu. Exactly what the other pair did in the point prior.
19-20.
Complementing each other so well. The youngsters, the far end. But in credit to the team Leo, they have sent out a really strong message that we are giving nothing away easily. Whatever you win, you're going to have to earn it very, very hard. It's been a tough mental battle, this, for these two. Haven't been a game up. But now they've got their work cut out because this seems to be levelling up nicely. Still 5 game point opportunities then for the Luos. And there it is. Persistence acknowledged. And the two top seeds claw their way back into this match. They're delighted. They're a game apiece. It's all to play for in the deciding game upcoming after the change of ends. They threw the kitchen sink out the two reds to no avail at the end. They kept their nose in front throughout that second game. Playing some really good badminton, the Luos. Yeah, really, now your money would be on the experienced duo of the top seeds at this stage. After 49 minutes played, then they've leveled up this encounter. All to play for. The winner's check, the adulation, the adoration, the ranking points. These two, well, really good work. So, who's it going to be in this one game shootout?
Final game, level play.
Luo Ying and Luo Yu to serve to get us underway in this deciding game. Remember, men's doubles follows this women's doubles final. Three down, two to go.
One love.
And a collective sigh around the arena. People coming back into their seats desperately to catch a glimpse of this deciding game in the women's doubles. It's been engaging throughout. It's all been about immaculate defensive skills. Well played. Good start from the top seeds. Carrying on in the manner in which they finished the second game. Now, can the youngsters respond? Was a feature of what happened in the second game. The Reds just so good at diffusing the attack from the youngsters, but not so then. Jia having the last laugh. Stake here, so many ranking points, prize money. Really, the youngsters would go up in the pecking order back home. So scoreboard symmetry then, nothing between them now. Game all, three all. Look at this, got a little lucky there, Xia, off of the net tape. Which way is this one going to swing now? Both players, both teams, I should say, with a chance to get both hands on this match right now. Who's going to step up? It's almost like both teams have to draw their opposing team to the net with some really short shots. And then the power on the smash, just enough to get through.
Four, three.
That was struck venomously. Directed well as well, right towards the body. Handcuffing Xia in response. So the final game then, always the toughest to win. Oh, that was nice. That was really nice off the backhand.
5-3.
Absorbing the pace so well throughout the rally. And look at that. A stroke of genius. And a fist pump in acknowledgement.
5-3.
So they've been detained for 4 minutes shy of an hour out here in this women's doubles final. But they've got vast match IQ. And they've teased out and induced a lot of errors from the youngsters. And there's another.
6-3.
You'd imagine frustration mounting in their young minds. Only 18, both of them. It's a lot of pressure to bear. So has the belief drained out of the yellow and blues? These two, former world number one, so much experience to draw on. Holders in this event last year, Tang Jianhua and Zhong Kuan Seng. Zhong played with Huang Dongpin in the doubles. They lost out in the semi-finals yesterday, having to withdraw after a game and 3-4. Not entirely sure why. Some sort of injury, I would imagine. I don't know whether that was Zhong or Huang.
5-6.
They made it all the way to the semi-finals anyway with a fresh partner, De Jong. Not playing with Tang this year, playing with Huang. Sounds like, but not quite the same. Now, that could prove costly.
7-5.
Well, it was only a month ago that they lost to these two at the All England Open on the 10th of March. Top seeds, as they were then in that tournament as well, winning 21-15, 21-17. So the youngsters have exceeded themselves already by taking that opening game. So 3 points between them. Then we've got a little bit of an issue. Frantic gesturing from Ching Chen. And a wince. Let's hope she's okay and able to carry on. Just bring stretched as we speak by the tournament doctor. Demands of pro sport, so grueling physically at this level. This is tough on the top seeds as well. Leading by 3 points, 8-5 up in the deciding game. They've been out on court just 1 minute inside an hour. And, you know, it's just, it's a chance for the underdogs to kind of break their momentum a little, and give them a little bit of thinking time as well. I mean, although I'm sure Cheng's mind will be on the injury, which is priority number one, if it is an injury, let's say. But some taping will be applied. Let's hope she's okay. We do hate to see this. So just relaxing the muscle. That's enough. The crowd delighted that she's up, indicating that she's hopeful to return to court. Remember, this is her second match today. She played in the mixed doubles earlier with Zheng Siwei. So just a little tape being applied to the right quad then. Well, she's all bound up like a mummy. And this one goes on as well. So let's hope that's not too cumbersome and that she can move around okay. Let's hope it's just a little strain and nothing too cumbersome. Well, we'll soon find out if her movement's inhibited in any way, but good to see Ching Chen back to the court, and the match will resume. 8-5 in favour of the Reds, the top seeds, Luo Ying and Luo Yu. Women's doubles final here, nearing its conclusion, you'd imagine. Top seeds, in the evidence of what we've seen, just grabbing back the momentum early in the second game and not relinquishing that control. Beautifully executed from Jia Yifan there, the lefty. Another mesmerizing point. Chen delighted. Well, she seems unhindered and unhampered by this leg issue, thankfully. Oh, poor leave.
Service over. 9-6.
So these two have demonstrated such patience and deliberation and insistence on finding a way through. Tactically, they've kind of worked it out. Not being too greedy with their choices, strengthening up their defenses and giving very little away. So, 4-point game. Two in a row, for the Luos. It's out, and as we head to the mid-game interval then, in game three, top seeds, five-point advantage. Long, drawn-out rallies have been a real feature of this one. Yeah, you can see by our replay, that was a little way out. Chen taking the leadership role. Have they got what it takes to turn this one around now, the youngsters? It's a big ask. Momentum very much against them. They're going to have to change something tactically. Seven minutes played, 5-point advantage
11.
For Luo Yin and Luo Yu. Wonderful, quick to bounce. Nothing wrong with that leg now. Now, is that going to ignite their cause? Just what they needed, hitting to the space so well and quick to close. Kitchen sink at the top seeds right now. They were proving a tough limpet to remove. They really are so solid in defense. Asking questions time and again of the youngsters' attacking skills. Two in a row. Jia and Chen. Make that three. They're on the way back into this 11. One, you sense. 2 points shy now. The five-point lead has evaporated to a one-point lead.
11.
And a look of disbelief on her face, frustration mounting. Turmoil in the camp. She's missed it.
12-10.
Now, is this enough for the top seeds to snatch back the momentum? Can they run with this lead now? In the driving seat at that point, and she knows it. Well, it's positive court positioning in their defence, but not good execution on the last two in a row for Zhao Yifan. Well, we know these two can mix it with the best because they are right now. But have they got enough to cross the finish line? A desperate roar of approval from them both. Mini implosion occurring here.
Late.
But you have to give credit to the immaculate defensive skills of the top seeds. Once Chen had committed to this, there was no going back and a big hole on the court as a consequence. Zhao Yifan showing willing, too much court to close down there. Just as you think, as it's all starting to unravel for the youngsters, suddenly a point their way. Can they build from here? All four players on the court playing some terrific badminton. Nice body shot finish. Challenge waning now from the two youngsters. 5 points adrift. Top seeds, 4 points from the W. And surely they're going to get there first on the evidence of what we've seen of late, last couple of games. Can't see them being denied right now. Over an hour and a quarter now on court. Contrast in body language from both teams. Slight despondency from the yellow and blues. Conversely, the reds calm, deliberate, precise in their rituals. And a hop and a skip of delight after that point. They're not done yet. But calm reassurance from the senior seeds in red. They're making them work extremely hard for every point. Indeed, it's been a grueling match throughout. Generous applause.
Thank you.
They've given their all, both teams out here. They've been so focused. So physically resilient to sustain this level of intensity for this long. So a much needed rest as they wring out their hair and reassemble it. It's been a grueling contest. Almost 80 minutes played, 18-15 in the deciding game, the score in favor of the top seeds. Now, can these two youngsters, Jia and Chen, mount a comeback? Yes! To the crowd's delight, they're making a fist of this. 2 points shy of the opponent's score. So from 18-13, 3 points in a row for the young underdogs. showing real character. There's something fearless about being young, isn't there, in sport? Wow. Against all odds, they've leveled up. Hesitancy down the middle of the court. Top seeds and winners of the Dubai World Super Series finals last year. Unsure. For the youngsters,
18.
But not to be six. Oh, she did all the right things. The racket angle just slightly closed. Right. That was all. Millimeters. Finish there.
18.
So after 83 minutes played then, two championships points to Luo Ying. Luo Yu. Scenes. It was a mighty tough hurdle, but the top seeds survive after a grueling contest, and you have to say the winner is the Chinese badminton development program, frankly, because, well, what a grand job. These two all smiles, as well they should be. Only played two tournaments this year. This is the third, but they came good. So, a just result, some immaculate defensive plays from the top seeds, who asked endless questions of the aggressors, and in the end they spilt too many errors, and the Luos come through. Hugs all round, delight on their faces. They withstood a huge challenge from the youngsters, but the Reds beat the Yellows in that all-Chinese encounter. Confirmation of the score, 16-21, 21-15, 21-18, after 85 minutes. Top seeds through in three games. So, we will await our presentation. And don't go anywhere. We'll have our men's doubles up next for you after this.
Thank you. 中国羽毛球大师赛、世界羽联黄金大奖赛、金管家杯女子双打颁奖仪式现在开始，请获奖运动员入场。
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now about to start the awarding ceremony for women's doubles play for the gold medal cup at the 2016 Bonnie China Masters, part of the BWF Grand Prix Gold Series. Now let our welcome our honorable players.
获得女子双打亚军的是中国陈清晨、贾一凡。
The runners up of women's doubles are 陈清晨、贾一凡、China.
Oh, they worked so hard, didn't they? The two youngsters.
中国若隐若雨。
To no avail in the end.
The women's doubles are 若隐若雨、China.
But what a match it was! Such a watchable.Intriguing match. You didn't quite know which way it was going to swing in the end. Mr. Zhang Donghei, Vice Director of the Standing Committee of the People's Congress, then presenting the trophies to the runners up and the winners.But it's Lu Ying and Lu Yu, the titlists, all smiles all round.
Let's welcome Mr. Zhang Donghei, Vice Director of the Standing Committee of People's Conference, to present the medals.
Mr. Li Yibing, Secretary General of the Jiangsu Province Sports Federation, presenting the mascots.
有请金管家商业服务有限公司董事长徐海松先生为获奖运动员颁发奖金。
Well, it's a glittering career ahead, you'd imagine, for Chen Qingchen and Jia Yifan, both only 18 years old. So, Mr. QHeysong, President of the Gold Manager Commercial Services Company Limited, to present the prize money. So it'll be photos next. And, delight on the faces of all competitors. That's nice to see in defeat as well as victory. Proud moments all around. Terrific scenes here in Shenzhou.It's been brilliantly staged, and I'm sure the celebrations will continue for these players. They've all worked so tirelessly all week, and it's a wonderful final to watch.